I don't know. Maybe it's an interesting thought. I was thinking, when I wrote the book, I was thinking about the prosecutor that really tried to catch Allan Carson for murder or... what do the courts say? If you're 100 years old, you sentence them to lifetime or what? And I guess he's kind of right when he thinks that since I'm on overtime, when it comes to age, I can do whatever I want. Oh, I've been thinking a lot about that. I don't know. I was so afraid before coming to France that you wouldn't understand the humor in my book. And you did. So obviously it's French humor as well. So I think that I represent Jonas Jonasson humor. Every other kiss, I guess she's not for me. You should sense our climate, then you would understand. I think the record last winter was 44.8 degrees minus. What can you do but laugh about it? Oh, I'm so happy that I waited, because I always considered myself being an author from the age of 18 or something like that. And I had the skill technically, but if I had had the time to finish my book when I was, let's say, 23, 24 years old, I would have stared at, you know, Milan Kundera or García Márquez or Vargas Llosa and a mixture of everything, and for sure it wouldn't have been me. Instead, I started when I was 47, and I had all the experience and the self-confidence to write exactly the book I wanted to read myself. Waiting to become 47, so I would be mature enough. No, you know, I worked as a journalist for many years, and then I started a media consultant company, and we grow from 2 people to 100 in a few years, and everything went very fast. Until it was too fast, and I became sick actually, and we sold the company, and finally I was at the age, finally I was ready to change my life, to become the author I was all the time. This story and various other similar stories full of hope and joy and satire and odd characters meeting society, and you, in the end, you don't know who's right, the odd character or the society. The reason why I started with this story, the 100-year-old man, was partly because of the title. The Swedish title is different from the French title. It is something like the 100-year-old man who climbed out through the window and disappeared, or something like that. Very long title. And once I invented the title, I became so curious myself. So first of all, I had to write the story. You could say that. I have a working title on the second book, The Analphabet Who Knew How to Count. I won't tell you more.